Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the CMA Game Show! And here is your host, Susie Starliner!
Here's Tom.
He's a ladies' man. Welcome to the CMA Game Show. We're all about creativity.
Time out. Susie, I think you could use one of these.
Oh, Tic Tac. I'd love one, Todd. Minty. All right. We need you, the audience, to show us how it's done. There will be two rounds? Followed by a final round with the contestants who won from the first two rounds. So we need you to show us some creative cojones.
Are you ready to get creative?
Woo! Woo!
Tell them about the first game here. Oh, wait, we should probably pick some contestants.
I think it's time to pick up some contestants. Pick some contestants.
Yeah, you're trying to pick them up.
Woo!
I'm going to pick
Get
the first
there,
one.
Get in there, Todd.
Adam Vitel. Wait,
Ooh,
did I read that right?
Adam Keitel.
Keitel. All right, Adam. Come on up. Woo!
Ooh, Adam is a recent grad from Pickerington, Ohio.
All right.
He loves to go biking, and he hearts mustaches.
Woo! Come He's on at the up, right
Adam.
Place.
Woo! Making me dizzy.
Yeah. Sarah McMains, come on down or up.
Welcome, Sarah.
Tell us about Sarah.
Sarah's a freelance graphic designer from Galena, Ohio. She loves to read and she loves glitter nail polish. I do too. I love glitter nail polish.
Give it a good spin, Susie. Oh, yeah.
There it goes.
That's pretty good.
Great.
Let me pick one more.
Thanks, Dad.
Aaron Hendricks, come on up. Woo!
Aaron. What do we know about Aaron? Oh, Aaron's a librarian.
Yay!
Woo!
I think she might have a naughty side, too. She's from Wellington, Ohio. She loves learning about drinking and, wait, learning about and drinking beer. I think she loves beer. And an interesting thing about Erin is she's a twin.
Oh my God, I knew there were two beautiful girls here. I thought I was seeing double earlier.
Double trouble.
Wow.
Oh, I am so excited. Thanks, Vetiver. I think it's time for
there
our
you go.
First challenge.
This, this game is called Yank the Lizard. Tell them how that goes, Susie, because I'm sure
okay.
you got a pretty good idea how that goes.
Yank the Lizard. Contestants, do you think you can wrangle this reptile? You're going to need to use all of these materials to rustle up this loony lizard and drag him back to your side of the ranch. So when you're ready to make your move, you're going to step behind this line and toss away. The first contestant to successfully corral that horned horror wins. And remember, you must stay behind this line. Are we ready to start our timer, Tom?
We are, but why don't you remind them how much time they have? Because I don't even think you said it, Susie.
4 minutes.
Try 3 minutes. You've got 3 minutes,
Whatever
guys.
Whatever you say, Todd, control freak.
All right, here we go. Ready, set, go.
All right.
1 second. 5 seconds has expanded. So Aaron, are you single or what's going on with you? What's his name?
Oh, Todd.
Paul Helsel. Where's that guy? Oh, there it is.
Where's Paul? Ooh,
lucky guy. Wow.
I give him some smooches. Oh, okay. Now remember, you're going to need a really toss it.
Scissors.
You need to go real far.
Someone will want to get up there and start tossing soon.
Oh, yeah. Probably the hardest challenge, I think. I know Todd had a lot of problems with it. You guys,
You guys are looking about 2 minutes left. I haven't even seen one toss. 1 minute has expired. Get to that line, guys. Cheer on your favorite contestant. How about for contestant number two?
Oh,
and contestant number three, don't forget about her. Kind of the crowd favorite, all right. And we got about a minute and a half left. Still not even a toss. Come on, Aaron, you can do it. Here we go, first, she's got the scissors involved, wow. Whoa, that's all right.
Okay, you can go back to get it. Toddle.
You can keep tossing. You guys can fight each other for the throwing it too. Don't be friendly. A little friend there. Oh my God. Wow, we got a winner.
Woo.
Follow me, losers. That was great.
Guys, it's great to have you. See you later.
Thanks for playing.
Okay. Aaron.
Well, I think she won a prize, but I don't know what it is.
Come get your fabulous prize package, Aaron.
Step on up, Aaron. Don't be shy.
She's a little shy. What?
Oh!
It's a gift card.
And Aaron, how far away from Jenny's ice cream do you think you live?
Probably like 2 minute walk.
Perfect gift. There you go, Paul.
Jenny's Blended Ice Cream, family owned.
And since you won, Aaron, sit in one of those reserved seats. Your pick.
Thanks, Todd.
No problem.
Okay. I think it's time to call some new contestants for our next round. What's the next challenge, Todd?
It's called Magnetic Personality. And once they bring it out, we will tell you all about it. But first, we got to pick some peeps. Give it a spin. Not that many names left. Odds are you're going to get picked.
So there is a huge crowd here tonight.
Matthew Dyer, the HR guy. Woo! Oh, wow. Tell us a little bit about it.
Matthew looks so excited. He is an HR guy from German Village. And his favorite hobby is ending death by PowerPoint. I can get by that.
Any comments about you being picked? That's why I said.
Matthew, could you try to make a three with your right hand? He can't do it!
Unless you.
Ah!
There you go. Now you got it.
Woo. All right, hands off, Susie.
Is it warm in here?
Oh, ow! Steve Sims, come on down.
Steve Sims?
Oh, Steve Sims? Come on down. Are you Steve Sims? Steve Sims coming up.
A handsome gentleman.
Susie, there's a lot of guys up here. Try not to sleep with any of the contestants. You have a history.
Ooh, a lot of gentlemen up here tonight. Oh, Steve Sims is retired from Miller's Court. His favorite hobby is being a grandpa, and he loves boats. He's retired from the Navy, and he's navigated all around the world. Woo! Great to meet you.
Give it another spin, Susie. Jonathan Martin, or no, Jordan Martin, come on up. Where's Jordan at?
Martin! Woo. Jordan Martin! Let's hope.
Jordan, here's Martin. A flower from Todd Tabler, courtesy.
She's from Columbus.
It's nice to have you here.
Welcome, Jordan. Her favorite hobby is laughing and. I like laughing.
She likes laughing. Whoa. It's called Magnetic Personality, but I have no idea how it's played, so you better tell them, because
all right.
You haven't been doing a very good job of that so far.
Okay, contestant, we're going to need you to show us your true self. So, we've got these magnetic pieces here. You're going to slap them up on this board to show us the real you. Now, of course, your fabulous features are fascinating, But don't limit yourself to creating a likeness. Any way you choose to represent yourself is encouraged. So you have 3 minutes.
3 minutes.
To tell us about, to do it, and then 10 seconds to tell us about.
Just 10 seconds.
And then the audience gets to pick who has done the most creative job of representing themselves. Are you ready to get started?
Yes!
Okay, Todd.
All right, let's get creative. Woo! Cheer back. Give it up for contestant one. He needs a little fire behind his furnace. How about the young lady in the middle, contestant number two? And the wise guy on the side, contestant number three.
Woo! Woo! JoJo's fast.
All right, a little here. Bart Simpson here going on already.
Not really seeing it come together here, but I'm sure he's got it.
Yeah, I'm sure he's got it planned out, but right now I see not much. Wow. Whoa.
Who's
are you done?
Who's he ready? Yes.
You are not. Whoa, that is actually great.
Is that a lip or a nose? Are you an artist?
That's gotta be an artist.
Yeah. She's an artist. Oh my goodness.
Wow, ooh. She proved a point.
You got this? We're not done yet.
It's not a time thing, it's a quality thing.
Quality out. Not everybody can just throw something out there and just make it.
Wow, here we go. You want to step away for a second? Give them a chance to see what you got so far? Look at that. Give it up. Not too shabby.
I think this might be a year.
You can be really cocky and just walk away. You can be like, I've done enough. But don't leave the stage. Please don't leave the stage.
Don't take advice from
Todd. Tabler.
Don't take advice from Todd.
Oh, yeah, Susie, you're just jealous.
I can see.
We got 1.5 minutes left. Jordan already is done. Once again, give it up for that. Oh, we got another completed piece?
Let's give a whoop whoop for Jordan. Oh, we've got another.
Wow.
Finish. Oh, portrait. Ooh. I like what's happening down here. They look like thick little legs.
Wow, we got a pretty dense piece over here.
Dense.
We're gonna count down 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 1,
1.
Game show, how did I skip a second? That's your fault, Susie.
You don't know numbers.
You're the worst.
Okay, audience, are you ready to help us pick the winner?
They've got 10 seconds to say what they like.
We need to hear what you have to say about your piece.
It's a gay pink whale with a mustache. swimming in the water with the rock behind him and the clouds above him and in the sky.
Not bad. Wow. Not bad. I just wanted to capture the true greatness of me. I wanted to kind of accentuate the ephemeral quality of life. I wanted to...
And that's 10 seconds, Jordan. Thanks
Sorry,
a lot. That was
no,
great.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Great.
All right, sir.
Number two. Well, everything here is obviously is very mixed up, and I want everybody to focus on the crown and after that, forget the rest of them.
The king. All right, everybody. Let's cheer for the best one. We got the king over here, the king of Millersport.
Pick your favorite.
King of Millersport. And we got the young, sassy Jordan who did it in 20 seconds
Jordan
and is happy with
artist.
It, but explained it for longer than she worked on it. But it was great.
Woo!
Thank you for the
Do you give it to me? She's so desperate. And what do you think, Todd?
I think we're going to have to do one more round of cheering because it all sounded the same to me.
What were
the King of Millersport? The promising young lady in the middle.
Oh,
you can see it.
Oh.
Come on up and get your prize.
I think the king deserves it.
The king, would you like a prize?
Would you like a prize? Come on out. Let's give another round of applause for the king.
What a good, wait, let's give a round of applause for this good-looking crowd, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Tell them about
this?
The prize, Susie.
It's a gift certificate from Spoonful Records. Yeah. There you go.
Yeah. Where's that located, Susie?
Spoonful Records is downtown Columbus's only vinyl record shop, featuring new and vintage vinyl LPs and 45s. Cool.
Hip.
Yeah. Really hip. Okay, I think might be ready to call up the contestants for our final round.
Let's call them back up. You two know who you are. There's only two of you. Please come back up.
Can we get
please?
The winners? Can we get the first two winners back up on the stage?
Final round, guys. Competing for the grand prize.
Stand on the pink one and the orange one. My favorite colors. Okay. Woo.
This has really been fun, Susie.
This has been fun. It's been a long time.
Where I am.
Who is that?
Oh, can somebody help me, please? Can anyone find my porter, the guy with my bag? Oh, I knew I shouldn't have let a real estate agent book a safari. You know, the only reason that I went on this safari was because Marlon, he's my omnipuncturist. Darling, do you see an omnipuncturist? No? Oh, you should go. It's Marlon. Marlon told me that it would help with my sciatic asthma. Sometimes it makes me breathe like this. So he says long walks, the great outdoors. Does he say parasites? No. Does he say biting tsetse flies? No. He doesn't say any of that. Oh, this whole harebrained mess is just so ridiculous.
Oh, hi, Ivana. My favorite is Frenemy, Ivana. Stolichnaya.
Susie Starliner, fancy seeing you here. You know, the whole reason I agreed to go on safari was to get a glimpse of the rare and spectacular Heflactopus. Did I see a Heflactopus on safari? No, I did not. Do you think that I even saw the trail that a little Heflactopus would leave behind? No, I didn't. Do you think I got a glimpse of the existence of a Heflactopus? I did not. But now I'm just so thirsty. I don't even think a Heflactopus even exists.
We're gonna take a first drink.
Get a drink of water, Todd.
Let's get a drink.
Oh, a gentleman. Oh, hello.
Todd Taylor, actually. Tap it out.
Todd doesn't have a lot of taste. Okay. Okay, winner.
You know what? You have tasted too many things. By too many things, I mean men.
Okay, winners. Now that maddening madam won't leave for good unless we satisfy her safari. So the only way to do that is if we deliver her a Heflactopus. Now, what is a Heflactopus, you may ask? Well, it's only the most bizarre, unique, crazy, weird, grotesque, inexplicable animal this side of the Earth. So that's why this day we call
Radical Animals! And I knew that, Susie. Don't jump on my lines. I'm tired of you jumping on my lines.
We'll talk about this later. Okay, contestants. We need you to make a Heflactopus that Ivana thinks is the real thing.
The real McCoy.
You'll need to use these materials to create your critter, and Ivana will be back in just 5 minutes. So when she does, you'll have 15 seconds to convince her that these are Heflactopuses, and you can expound upon your beast. So whichever contestant does the best job at fooling Ivana wins a fabulous prize package. Okay?
Are they going to get any help?
I
think they should get an assistant.
Creating forms of life isn't easy, so I suppose you can recruit one assistant from the studio audience. Who would you like?
I would like my twin.
Oh, wow.
Twin power, come on up.
All right. And sir, who would you like to select as your partner? Or assistant? All right. Come on up.
Ooh, I can't wait to see these Heflactopuses.
And when it is completed, you will set it on the carpet circle, correct, right. Susie? Or not?
Heflin,
was that something you were supposed to tell them? Or am I feeding your lines?
I don't think so, Todd. Heflin would not ever hang out on the table. That's not going to convince a bottom. You'll need to put it on the carpet when you're finished. Todd, are we?
Excuse me, I'm talking to someone. You always get jealous. Stop, Susie. Anyway, you guys are going to actually have 4 minutes for this activity. And we are going to start it right now.
Go! This can be the body, but it doesn't have to be.
There and tails and eyes, pipe cleaners, pom poms,
eyeballs.
Right, let's see how the twins are doing over here. Give up for the twins. Who's a fan of the twins up here? They're kind of automatically likable because they're twins. You got that advantage going for you guys. Yes.
Device happening on here.
It's looking kind of cute.
Like
one eye though.
Kind of cute. I'd pay a dollar for that. Let's go to Petland.
Use everything. Come on, guys. Get wild. Get creative.
Oh, I like these sparkles.
So what are you actually doing right here? What's going on?
Yours. Hey.
Well, it's working, girl. It's working. This is actually looking pretty decent too.
I don't know if these will convince Ivana. She's been on more than one safari, if you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah. I've been on a safari with her.
She's lived a good life.
All right, 2 minutes have expired. We got 2 minutes left. It's kind of the middle point.
Yeah,
rally them up. Give them a little fire.
Let's give a cheer for the king.
Will you show the crowd what you got so far? Will you just hold it up and show them? Oh. Oh, wow. Sassy twin.
I heard mustache from the audience. I think a helpful octopus might grow a hearty mustache.
All right, a minute and a half left.
Didn't you say that 2 minutes ago?
Whatever, Susie. Who did they trust with the stopwatch?
Did you ever actually learn how to tell time, Todd?
Whatever. You're terrible. Why don't you just go sleep with all the contestants?
Good comeback!
You always do anyway.
You're so stupid! You're so stupid!
God, you're annoying! I'm gonna stand on this side. Alright, 1 minute left! 1 minute left!
This one's cute! I'm gonna name him Heffy. I like his eyebrows.
All right, it's almost over. Give him one more round of applause to kind of fire him up a little bit. Yeah. 30 seconds left. Final push, guys. These things are starting to come together.
I don't think Ivana's going to know. I don't think she's going to know.
And 15. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10,
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Game show!
Okay, now set your Heflin octopuses down in their natural environment before Ivana gets back.
All right, we need to put place the animal in its natural environment, which is the
She's
carpet
gonna be back
circle.
In a second.
Wow, we got two good ones. Get a load of this. Wow. Smashing, baby.
Oh, here she is.
Susie Starliner, are you there?
I'm right.
You want me to close my eyes, but a surprise for me.
You can open your eyes now, Ivana. We've got some heffalactopuses here for you.
Don't you mean heffalactopies?
Yeah! Pie! Check them out, what do you think?
Let's see if you've got the real deal here. I do love a heffalactopus with a mustache, I do say. What else have we got over here?
If you cross that with a zebra, I have no idea what you would have.
Probably something like Todd Tabler. Ooh, bird. Bird. Okay. Okay. Let's see what Anna has to say. Or Ivana. Anna.
I have to say, Susie Starliner, I didn't think you'd come through for me. But I've always known that a true heffalactopus would have a mustache! Yeah! Yeah.
Yep, that's the one! I knew you'd know when you saw it. Oh, I knew you'd know.
Schnuckums, do you want a new mommy? Come on!
Okay, looks like she bought it. Okay, well, it looks like our grand prize winner.
Here it comes.
What do you think she's won? Go on up.
Wow.
Take a look.
There's all kinds of good stuff.
Oh, it looks like a brand new toaster. Now, two slice vintage look toaster, except whole wheat, fried, sourdough.
I know what, Susie.
And even bagels. Ooh, we also have a complimentary membership to the Columbus Museum of Art and a 3-week supply of turtle wax. Thanks, Erin. You did a great job. Let's give her a round of applause. Woo! Well, I hope you've all had a great time at CMA's game show.
I know I did.
Yeah, I'm sure you did. Remember, everybody, eliminate the hate.
Elevate your mind.
And create!
Top Tabler. Tab and I.
Thanks, guys. Can we get the rest of the crew up here? Where's our crew?
Come on, turtleneck. Red pants.